This dad thought his son was in Afghanistan, but his epic homecoming was just around the corner. Sitting on the floor at home, Brian Honia plays with his phone. There's a tree by the fireplace and stockings hang from the mantel. It reflects the homes of many families at Christmas. But for Brian, there's something missing. His son, Bryce. However, while his dad thought he was serving in Afghanistan, their reunion was closer than Brian realized. Before we begin, make sure to smash that like button, subscribe to our channel, click the notification bell to be inspired by these heartwarming stories every day. Christmas is a time for families. So, for those who have loved ones far away, for example, serving in the military, it can be a particularly tough period of the year. Being stationed overseas can lead to sons, daughters, fathers, wives, and siblings, and others being absent. As a result, time spent with such family members is particularly treasured. Although we live in a highly connected era where no one is more than a click away on the likes of Facebook and Instagram, there's nothing that compares to the connection of a warm hug from a loved one. Brian is one such father, whose son was serving in the Marines. And for Brian, the bond he had with his son, Bryce, was especially strong. As a single father, Brian had raised his son all on his own. And as a result, ever since Bryce was 8, they'd been pretty much inseparable. Upon leaving high school, Bryce opted to embark on a military career and signed up to be a Marine. Training is infamously brutal for those who wish to enlist. As the Marine Recruits website states, battles are won by overpowering the desire to quit with the perseverance to prevail. Indeed, training for the Marines is initially set at 3 punishing months. And that's just to test whether recruits meet the necessary requirements to successfully progress. Only then will full training begin in a career specialty, which recruits select during the enlistment process. It was this prolonged training regime, then, that kept Bryce away from his dad and stepmom Ashley for more than 12 months. And it looked as though Bryce would miss Christmas 2016 with his family in Peoria, Illinois, due to his military responsibilities. At least, that's what he told his dad. As Ashley explained in a Facebook post in December 2017, Bryce had told Brian he couldn't be home for Christmas because they were sending him off for more training before he gets deployed. We haven't seen him since last Christmas. A tough break indeed. Still, Brian was at least surrounded by the rest of his family. There was his wife, Ashley, and 2 further sons, Crew and Rye. Also present that Christmas were Bryce's grandparents. But even so, nothing could hide Brian's disappointment at his son not making it home for the holidays. But Bryce and Ashley had a plan. Little did Brian know, but he would be reuniting with his Marine son sooner than he realized. It was a surprise that the pair had been plotting for months, and it wasn't an easy mission to keep the ploy to themselves. As Ashley explained, it was tough keeping it secret because he would call while Brian was around and I would have to come up with a reason. Consequently, when the Christmas period drew closer, it appeared that Ashley was running out of excuses for her phone calls. So what were Bryce and his stepmom plotting between them? Well, all was revealed in a video that Ashley posted to her Facebook profile on December 23, 2016. The scene is very festive. The Christmas tree is decorated and the stockings are hanging from the fireplace. Brian is sitting on the floor, propped up against the couch. His phone's in his hands and he's staring at it intently. Being so close to Christmas, could it be that he's expecting a call from his son, whom he believes to be overseas due to his Marine training? Bryce, however, isn't the only thing missing from the family home. The tree has no gifts underneath it. But then a voice comes calling from the hallway. It belongs to family friend Kelly Campbell, who has come bearing presents. The picture then is almost complete. Brian seems to barely look up from his phone as Kelly walks into the room. But then she does something that finally catches his attention. You see, gifts aren't the only thing that she's brought with her. Something else is lurking in the hallway. Or rather, someone else. Following Kelly into the room is none other than Bryce himself. For months, he'd been plotting with Ashley to arrange his travel to get home for the holidays. It was a secret they'd struggled to keep for so long, given how close the family is, and well, sometimes these things can just slip out. But keep it a secret they did. And consequently, Brian's reaction is priceless. He throws down his phone, holds his head in his hands in disbelief and exclaims, "Shut the—" His self-censorship is commendable, even though it's easy enough to fill in the blanks of what he was about to say. Bryce walks over to his dad, who it seems is still trying to process what's happening. Finally, Brian stands up and gives his son a long and drawn-out hug. Understandable, since they haven't seen each other in a year. Brian is clearly overcome with emotion. Ashley, who's filming the surprise reunion, says from behind the lens, "Can we quit lying now?" A lie it may have been, but this was a charade that was played out with the best of intentions. It was well executed too. As Ashley admitted on Facebook, Ryan had no idea he would be home for Christmas. Family life with a Marine in the fold then can be tough, but stolen moments such as these make the hard times a little easier. And it's a vocation for Bryce that his parents are deeply supportive of. As Ashley wrote, "We're so very proud of the young man he's become. He has a heart of gold."